important for marital people. And because surely there is an end, because this year is ending, all forms of delay, be it marital or in any other area in your life, all forms of delay will end. Delay charge bearing will end. Delay settlement will end. Delay financial breakthrough will end. Delay progress will end. Delay positive decision on your applications will end. Wherever there is manifestation of delay, as this year is about to end, that will also end. Proverbs chapter 13, verse 12. Proverbs 13, 12 is the text of the message. Proverbs 13, 12. I read, "Hope deferred maketh the heart sick, but when the desire cometh, it is a tree of life." From the Living Bible translation, it says, "Hope deferred makes the heart sick, but when dreams come true at last, there is life and joy." Hope deferred makes the heart sick, but when dreams come true at last, there is life and joy. I see your dreams coming true at last. I see victory at last concerning your situation. Another translation says, "Delayed hope makes the heart sick, but fulfilled desire is a tree of life." Delayed hope makes the heart sick, but fulfilled desire is a tree of life. What does it mean to delay? To delay means to defer. It means prolonged manifestation. We learned from the scripture that we read that delay causes sickness, sickness of the heart. And most sicknesses in life start from the heart. When the heart, when the mind is sick, the entire body will begin to respond with sickness as well. And God has promised to take sicknesses away from our midst. And so if delay is one of the things that causes sicknesses, it follows that God will take delay away. Because delay can cause sickness. Sickness of the heart, and it can be followed with sickness of the body. Hypertensive condition, high blood pressure can follow when there is sickness of the heart. Because sickness of the heart will result in anxiety, in worries, and all those things can begin to raise one's blood pressure and begin to come up with terrible, tragic symptoms. What is marital delay? Marital delay means a delay or a deferment in getting married, even though a person is spiritually, biologically, emotionally mature to marry. Even though there is stability around you, you are reasonably stable in many ways and prepared and willing and ready, yet it is not happening. It is a marital delay, and it's not necessary from the Lord. Marital delay in this context also means delay in getting marital blessings. And one of marital blessings, for instance, is the fruit of the womb. Normally, you will love to get married before you begin to have the fruit of the womb. So if there is delayed marriage, for instance, it follows there is also delayed fruit of the womb. All manners of marital delay will end today. Your amen is on sabbatical. In one family, for example, we found two categories of sisters and brothers. There is category one, who suffered delayed marriage. Marriage didn't take place. The brothers, sisters, some of them are already in their 40s, 50s. Yes, they have never married. Then there's a second category in same family who suffered what I call delayed marital blessing, childbearing. Eventually, one or two or three of them got married, but then after they got married, 10 years into marriage, they are still child. So, in your family. And today, in the name of Jesus Christ, God is not pleased with delay in our life. In Deuteronomy chapter 2, after the children of Israel had circled Kadesh Barnea and a journey to the promised land that was supposed to take 38 days. 38 days journey took 40 years. 38 days journey took 40 years. So they just discovered that they were moving around in the circle. They would travel for a whole year, only to discover that where they started from in January is where they returned to in December. It was like an M25 kind of journey. M25 kind of journey syndrome will stop in your life. You know, M25 is Kadesh Barnea. Eh? You start from what? You know, M25 goes around London. It goes around. There are very close to where I live. There are two exits and entrance points to M25. And they are very close to one another. If you enter through that port tunnel, for instance, and you continue on the same road, you won't know. You will think that you are traveling on a straight road with maybe little bend. But you will just discover that at the end, if you don't know where you are going, you will just come out at the other end, exit, entrance. And you will discover that both entrances are just a few meters to one another. That's how close we are. So it's like the same point. So going around in a circle, they did that for 40 years. So where they were supposed to travel to within 38 days, it took them 40 years. And on the 40th year, to tell you that God does not like what was going on in their life, God spoke. God will speak today. God spoke in verse 3. He said to them, Deuteronomy chapter 2, verse 3, he said, you are compass this mountain long enough, turn you not more. That is to say, you have suffered long enough. Go, this is the right way. Today, God is saying to somebody, you have suffered delay long enough. There will be a turnaround. My God will give you a turning point in the name of Jesus. Delay means to retard. It means to slow down. It means to linger. It means to hinder. Delay means to prolong. Delay means to be long in showing up. It means to be long in manifesting. Delay means to block. Whatever is blocking your way to break through will be unblocked. Delay means to stop. It means to delay. Delay means to deny. Delay means to arrest. Arresters of your destiny are being arrested right away. Delay means to hold down or hold back. Whatever is holding you back from going forward is hereby broken. Delay means to be chained down. I command on this altar every chain that is not allowing you to make progress as programmed into your destiny by the Almighty God, the chain is thereby broken. That chain holding you down is broken. That chain that is saying no to marriage in your life is broken. That chain that is saying no to joy in your life is broken. That chain that is saying no to settlement in your life is broken. It's broken. In the name of Jesus Christ. This is a message that every one of us should take seriously. Why? Because as I'm sharing this word with you, there will be someone here who is either experiencing marital delay Do you? That is why this is a message that everybody should take serious. And when it's time to pray, pray with the whole of your heart. And every form of generational delay shall be broken. I say shall be broken. And your home may not even be marital delay, but there might not be another area of your life where there is delay or detention or arrest of God's promise manifesting and showing forth. In the same way, you must listen carefully because by and large, the same principles can be found in many of these forms of delay. The same principles can be found even as we go on. When there is marital delay, there are tragic consequences, unpalatable consequences, undesirable consequences when people experience marital delay or even any form of delay for that matter. Number one of such consequences is weariness or sickness of the heart. We learned about that in Proverbs 13:12. In Proverbs 13:12, that hope deferred or hope delayed maketh the heart to be sick. So when there is delay, the heart becomes sick. You become weary. You become weak. You are getting tired. And if care is not taken, it can begin to manifest in your general health and well-being. Another consequence of marital delay is what we call discouragement. Everybody say discouragement. Discouragement can set in, beloved. We are human beings. And human beings can be discouraged. God knew that discouragement will set in. We tried to attack Joshua. When in Joshua chapter 1, verse 8, verse 6 to 8, he began to tell Joshua to be strong and be of good courage. Because he knew that the enemy will fire the arrows of discouragement at some point in his life and in the assignment that God had given him to fulfill here on earth. Discouragement sets in when people experience marital or even any form of delay, for that matter. What is discouragement? Discouragement means the taking away of courage, the taking away of strength. Discouragement is a word that comprises two words, these and courage. These and courage. These means that we take away. Just as you have in the word disconnect. Disconnect. Disconnect means to remove connection. Everything disconnecting you from your blessing is thereby disconnected from your life. Disconnection. Or what you, there is also the word disease. Disease. It has two words there. Ease and ease. Ease is when you are well. You are at ease. Everything is okay. But disease means when the ease is taken away. And then you have disease. You have sickness. Every form of that has been added to your ease is hereby removed. Is hereby removed. Is hereby removed. In the name of Jesus. And on like that, dislocate, disadvantage, disorder. Discouragement sets in when there is delay. Another consequence of delay is frustration. Frustration. People can get frustrated as a result of delay. They get frustrated. They get tired of everything else. They don't want to belong anymore. They don't even want to do anything again. In fact, they begin to give up. When frustration, the spirit of frustration is telling you, give up. This thing cannot work. I say to you, it will work. I say it will work. The spirit of frustration is telling you, it is impossible. Don't bother any longer. I'm saying to you, you are marching to the year of possibilities. Tap three people and tell them it is possible. Oh, yes. But with my God, nothing is impossible. Nothing is impossible. Nothing is impossible. Nothing is impossible. Don't let anybody tell you any rubbish concerning that. This year alone, I've seen possibilities. I've seen possibilities. I've seen possibilities. I've seen a single mother of about 20-something years. I've seen a single mother got married this year in this church. In this church. It's possible. Praise the name. careful what they say to you. It's not because it's your fault entirely. It is because of the spirit of marital. But that spirit will die. And you will live. In Jesus' name. Delay may bring weeping. But I have good news for you today. Weeping may endure for a night. In the morning, cometh joy. I welcome you to your brand new morning of joy. It can bring the problem of doubting God. Delay, particularly marital delay, can make people to doubt God. Is there God again? Am I not praying? Am I not fasting? Am I not tithing? Am I not giving? What else do I need to do? Have I not kept myself holy all these years? Are people not getting married around me? Are people not getting married around me? It can make one to begin to question and doubt God. And Satan is very happy when you are doing that. Whatever is making the enemy to rejoice over you, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, he will arise and deliver you from this thing. God will arise, and the enemy's rejoicing over your situation shall be scattered. In the mighty name of Jesus. Delay can also lead to a backsliding life. Can lead to backsliding and sin. People can unwittingly and what they never imagined they would do, they can begin to do those things when there is marital delay. I know a lady who couldn't take it anymore. So she left her church, she left fellowship, and went ahead and just had a child out of wedlock. She couldn't take it anymore. I've waited. I'm already in my 40s. Very soon, according to doctors, menopause will take place. I want to have a child. God is not going to do it in this way that they are preaching to me. Let me just go and help myself. She went ahead, knew that the boyfriend wasn't ready to get married to her, but she knew what she wanted. She just wanted to get pregnant. But she knew that because the church does not preach that, and that would not be approved, she left her church and went and sinned against the Lord. Beloved, I want you to know, if the devil can use marital delay to get you to hell, he will do a good job at it. But it is left to you to say, nothing will separate me from the love of Christ, and nothing will separate me from my determination to make heaven. When God knows that you are determined, in spite of what you are going through, to make heaven, he will make every devil and every demon tormenting your life, he will make them to bow at your feet and give you victory over them. For some of us, what God is waiting for to give you your breakthrough is God wants that total assurance that no matter what, you are going to remain with Jesus. Delay is a terrible thing. It can make someone to become a victim of mocking and despising voices. Is it that brother that is not yet married, even though he's in his 50s? Is it that sister you are talking about that is not married, even though she's in her 50s? Mocking and despising voices can become to rise up as a result of marital delay. But God has sent me with good news to somebody here today. Every voice mocking and despising you is coming soon to celebrate you. To celebrate you. To celebrate you. To celebrate you. In the name of Jesus. Delay can lead to hopelessness and helplessness. And delay can make people to isolate themselves. To isolate themselves. And just wanting to be alone. And God loves that. When you are isolated, he comes to batter you hard. He batters you with frustration. He batters you with discouragement. Knowing that you are alone and you are not in the assembly of brethren. Knowing that you've forsaken other brethren, knowing that you've isolated yourself, you will come and pump in a lot of doubt into your heart. You know, when the lion wants to eat the antelope, what the lion is carefully waiting and looking for, he wants that antelope that is targeting to become isolated. As long as the antelope is walking within the rank and file of other antelope, I tell you what, the lion dare not move near. So, but the lion is far off, watching that procession of many, many antelopes that are going. Then occasionally, the lion will do what? The lion will roar. Satan took guns as a roaring lion. He will roar. Roar. You know, they call singles meeting, you don't even want to be there anymore. In fact, it's as if you don't regard yourself as a single anymore. What is causing that? The devil is behind it. He wants to isolate you. He wants to isolate you. And the moment he succeeds at doing that, you fire him off. And then his attack becomes stronger and fiercer against you. You will not be isolated. You will not become food for the lion. Say, I refuse to be food for the satanic lion. In the name of Jesus, I'm begging you, don't isolate yourself. Don't let the enemy succeed in that regard. You are nearer your breakthrough than you ever thought. And your breakthrough will manifest speedily and quickly. In the name of Jesus. Somebody has said, don't isolate yourself. Yes. Even God did not isolate himself. He has regular fellowship with his Son and the Holy Spirit. And every time he says, let us, let us, let us, let us. If God is not alone, you will not be alone. In Jesus' name. What are the causes of delay? Very quickly, we want to identify two categories of causes of marital delay. One is spiritual and one is physical. There can be spiritual causes and then physical causes. I'll run through them quickly. Number one, marital delay can be divine. Everybody say divine delay. It can be a divine delay. What is a divine delay? A divine delay is when God is behind it. After all, the Bible says God makes all things beautiful in his own time. God can be behind it for his purpose. He might have a purpose. There may be an assignment that you have to fulfill before you get married. And that could be a divine delay, for instance. There was a man of God that God wanted to reach some nations for him before he got married. So that man experienced marital delay, but why he wasn't bothered was that he had God spoke to him clearly. He saw somebody that he wanted to marry, and God spoke to him clearly, no, not now, not now, not now, not now. And he kept on doing his missionary work. And it was at the age of 55 that he finally got married. But you know the goodness and the kindness of God, God kept him strong, God kept him healthy, and he was in his happy marriage for another 40 years. He lived to be 95 years old, and he saw the children of his children. 40 years of happy married life. That is the form of divine delay. But you must be sure that it is divine delay. Don't allow Satan to confuse you and think that it is delay is divine if it is not divine. How do I know? Either God speaks to you expressly, and you have that conviction and that peace that this delay is from God. Or you have examined other factors and other possible causes of delay, and you know that none of them appears applicable to you. Yet, there is delay. Then there might be a divine delay. But even if divine delay has an end, there is a time when you must break through. Elizabeth experienced a divine delay because Elizabeth's womb had been prepared to give birth to a John the Baptist. And the John the Baptist must only be 6 months older than the Lord Jesus Christ. And there is an appointed time in the calendar of God when Jesus was born. So whichever womb will give birth to John the Baptist has no choice but to wait. That's a divine delay. That's a divine delay. The womb has to wait so that the birth of the child from that womb will not be more than 6 months older than Jesus Christ. Even the divine delay of Elizabeth came to an end. Your own divine delay too will come to a glorious end, a successful end. When the manifestation of God comes in the coming days and weeks and months, it shall be like a tree of life. It shall be like a tree of life. It shall be like a tree of life. In the name of Jesus. Marital delay can also be caused by what I call family yokes. Family yokes. And under this family yoke, there are many things there. Many things. One of them would be negative family pattern. If, for instance, in your family, there is regular, constant, people are experiencing marital delay. You have brought siblings who have been waiting for years before they got married. Or in your family, everybody has been waiting. Maybe it's only the last born that is married. So that, and people have been waiting 10, 15 years, it's not happening. 2, 3, 4, 5 people, and it's becoming a pattern. Then it's a family yoke. And every yoke must be broken by the reason of the anointing. Yokes were made not to live thought to be broken. So it would be a family pattern and a negative family pattern for that matter. Now, part of what we call family yoke, it could also be the problem of broken home. Broken home. Beloved, people who come from broken home, quite a number of them experience marital delay. Because broken home is not in the will of God. Amen? God hates the putting away. God hates divorce. So the moment a home, a marriage is broken, they have already broken God's covenant. They are already living in the displeasure of God. And one of the products of marriage is children. So everything our parents did to break the home, directly or indirectly, they affect children. They affect the children. Do two people go and divorce themselves and shake hands and say congratulations, except if it was an arranged marriage? But people don't shake their hands. They don't embrace themselves in the divorce court. They usually do it with bitterness, with anger, with animosity. And that's why if you have been in that area, you need serious repentance and crying to God so that there can be a clean slate. Or if you come from families of broken home, you are neither. That's why we can't take our Christianity on seriously. Because we have work to do. Because those things have a way of backfiring at us. Praise the name of the Lord. You know what I'm talking to you about now? There's nothing secret about it. I came from a broken home. It was after my parents gave their lives to Christ, that with prayer, with counseling, that God began to use me to bring them together so that at least they can live together under the same roof before my father finally passed away. But for many, many years, they were divorced, they left themselves. How many of us here, like myself, came from broken home? We have parents and no longer together. My hand is up, so there's nothing. God wants to deliver us, we must come out clean. Right. So you discover that those problems can affect us because of the words they spoke. I know the words my father used to speak to me. Not because of anything I've done wrong, but you will see that it is transferred animosity, transferred anger, transferred hostility and aggression. When your father looks at you and says that you, son of a useless man. Now, what a man like that is saying is that nothing good, nothing useful can come out of a useless man. But glory be to God. My God reversed those curses over my life. If not for Christ, those things would have been working against me. And I knew that my father said all those things, not because he was somebody that I do wrong. Because I look back and those times when he would curse and abuse me, I didn't do anything wrong. Maybe he sent me to go and buy a newspaper, and I bought the newspaper. I'm only a 6-year-old boy. And I'm walking down, and he will look at me and say, you are walking like that? I sent you a newspaper, and you are walking like that? I said, oh, am I walking, daddy? And then he will bring up, you know, us whip and beat me and beat you. Useless boy of a useless mother. Useless boy of a useless mother. Of a stupid one. Of a, and my mother. So I knew that I was not really the offender. It was my mother. I was being punished for the sins and Christ and Christ and offense of my mother. That's why till today is still a problem walking side by side with my wife. When we are walking together, I will have taken 10 steps ahead of her. And before I realize it, I will quickly run back to be on her side. And I will say to her, I know, thank God you understand. God told her the story that don't be me, oh. My father trained me that I must always be working like a soldier. Even when it's not necessary for me to work like that, I have to work like that because I receive beating for not working that way. And somebody shout hallelujah. Every satanic transfer of aggression against your destiny, I write it up by the blood of Jesus. I write up by the blood of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Many of us, our parents have spoken negative words at each other and affected us. Many of us, parents are fighting and they threw us down. They threw us down as babies because they are quarreling. Many of us, simply because your mother gave birth to you,
girl, and your father was expecting her to give birth to a boy, your mother committed a crime. And not only your mother, you also committed a crime. And so every time your mother looks at you, your mother is saying that it is this girl that brought sadness to my marriage. This man used to love me and used to care for me before I gave birth. But when I gave birth to this girl, I may be in heaven concerning the agenda and the destiny of God. That is the baby that will take care of a foot of you in your old age. And how many of you know that girls are wonderful as far as that is concerned? How many sons remain when you're already old? They go their own business. They are too busy. Is it not the girls that will come back and look after you? But do you know that it has been a crime, particularly from where you and I, many of us here came from, it has been a crime when a woman gives birth to a daughter. A friend of mine who gave birth, the wife gave birth to three daughters, a friend, who is supposed to know? If I tell you who this friend is in the faith, you'll be shocked. Now finally, the wife gave birth, now as their last daughter is 13 years old, that should tell you that they never stop looking for a boy. They give birth to three girls. Finally, the wife gave birth to a boy. A few weeks ago, a boy. They've had three girls. Finally, the wife gave birth to a boy. 3 weeks ago. You know what he said? I said to the woman. He said, finally, my only begotten son has come. My only begotten son has come. I read that message. I said, this man doesn't know what he's talking about. And if he's not careful, the kind of affection we pour on that child, the other girls will be looking and be looking. So we've been criminals in this house all these years. We ought to be careful as parents. Our parents were not that careful. So they brought all manners of delay, including marital delay. A baby that you keep seeing all the time and you are not really happy, because your husband is not happy that it's a girl. That baby, that girl, when she grows up, she's likely to have many challenges. Many, many challenges. Because you've rejected that child, and every day you are telling heaven to reject, to reject. And Satan is coming in, taking advantage of that to bastardize the destiny of that child. As many of you as the Lord is giving understanding of this message, may you be delivered. Today, not tomorrow, may you be delivered. Another junior brother or co-brother of this family yoke problem is what I call polygamy. The problem of polygamy, it will shock you that all these things have effect on our later life, even as products of those homes. They have effect. Polygamy breeds all manners of terrible things, immorality to start with, started from adultery to start with, and then deceives the children that came out of polygamy, war amongst the parents, you know. Remember the war between Rachel and Leah, even two sisters. Why all the parties were polygamy? Polygamy caused it. And look at the effect on the children. Look at the effect. It was that war, the product of that war, the consequence of that war, that did not make Reuben to enter. That made Reuben, the firstborn, to receive a curse. Because what did Reuben do? Reuben went and slept with the concubine of his father. And Reuben, when he was doing it, he felt justified. Why? Because as far as Reuben was concerned, if his father could sleep with two sisters. So Reuben saw that, what's the problem if I sleep with the girlfriend of my father? Or another wife of my father? That was Reuben's calculation. After all, Reuben slept with two sisters. So from the same children, and married them. So Reuben felt that there was no problem. And his father placed a curse for one. Plus all the crises between Rachel and Leah. All the infighting, and you know the battles in polygamous school. The battles. I came from a polygamous school. How many of you do in this place? How many of you do? Raise up your hand. Emma Bell, you have been delivered. Raise up your hand. You have been delivered. If I came from there and I'm still standing, you will stand and fulfill your destiny. The battles that went on in the home that I came from, between the mother and they put the husband in the middle, and the children at the surrounding, the battles that went on, the visitation to Abali, the competition to get the attention of the husband, as it was in the days of the Bible, so it is. about between Leah and Rachel. They were even going to get vegetable to catch the attention of the man. Cook soup to get catch the attention. That's who it was in our home. Polygamy. The problem of polygamy. It's a sin unto God. Remember today, Abraham's polygamous deal is what has led to the problem of the world today. The son of the bond woman versus the son of the promise, of the son of promise, the covenant. That's the battle. That's the battle of terrorism we are having today. Eh? If Abraham had only kept his trousers and folded it well and kept it for the wife, for Sarah alone, and kept believing God, the world would rather not have the problem of terrorism that we have today. All these are things that can lead to marital delay. I know a family, because of polygamy, the rival women went ahead and did all manner of occultic witchcraft powers and forced the daughters of the other woman that they will never get married and have husband. Why? They said, because that woman did not allow them to enjoy the man that they have come to share with her. So because you did not allow us to enjoy your husband with you, even though your husband came and was one that married, so they went and did and caused all her daughters that they would never get husband to marry and enjoy. And even if they get one to marry eventually, they will never enjoy it. And those daughters began to experience this problem. Until they ran to Christ, gave their life to Christ, had a message like this, had understanding, and went into what they are doing. And one after the other, they were delivered. Five of them traveled all the way from America. They traveled to come and meet us here over this year. Traveled to come and meet us here over this year. And we talk and talk and counsel this spiritual mapping of their family and discover that this was the root of the problem. Prayed prayers and the Lord uprooted that cause. And today, they are all free, enjoying marital. Five sisters traveled from all over the world, having and experiencing the same problem until they discovered that there was this cause that polygamy brought. Every evil cause that polygamy brought into your family tree, it is written, every plant in my heavenly Father has not planted shall be rooted down. I command them to be uprooted. 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 In the name of Jesus. Another cause of marital delay is the problem of spiritual spouse or evil sota. Spiritual spouse. They say to you that you are already married. They call themselves your husband in the spirit realm. You see yourself conducting marriage in your dream. You see yourself carrying babies in your hand. And so to have physical real marriage on earth becomes problematic. To have children on earth becomes problematic because there are satanic spiritual spouses that are claiming to have married you. I divorce you from such evil marriages. I dissolve those wicked marriages. They will not stand. Neither will they come to pass anymore. They will not afflict you anymore. If you have tied evil so tight with anyone in a previous relationship, I hereby severe your destiny from evil so tight in the name of Jesus. That's another terrible thing that can lead to marital delay. Evil so tight as a result of previous relationships. Your soul has been tied to them, and they tied your soul to them in the spirit realm, and they are saying, no, you are evil, You are on hook. You are not hook. You are not hook. The blood of Jesus brings about total and permanent separation in the name of Jesus. There's also the problem of evil mark. Evil mark of rejection can cause marital delay. In spite of everything going well for you, physically, materially, and everything, evil mark can stop people from proposing to you, whether you are a man or a woman. People don't just propose. When people look at you, they probably want to sleep with you, but they don't want to get married. There is an evil mark. It could be an evil mark of rejection. You don't mean, but they are the only one that can see. They too are not seeing anything in particular, but something keeps telling them, wait. Evil mark. That's why you can see beautiful sisters. Everything is okay. Statistics correct. Everything over correct. In good order. Perfect functioning. You know, order. Yes. Nobody is saying, I want you, I will do, I take you to the altar. Could be the same for a man. A man experiencing marital delay. Who says that men don't experience marital delay? They do. And you ask them, don't you want to get married? They say, I want to get married. So what's your problem? Wrong attraction could also be a problem of delay. Wrong attraction. Not that people are not coming, but wrong people are always coming. Wrong people. Wrong people are coming to make proposals. Why do I call them wrong? Even when you close your eyes, they are talking to you and proposing, I want to marry you. You close your eyes. With your eyes closed, you know that you are not compatible. With your eyes closed, you don't even have to open it or ask anything. You know that when they get there, it can be. But they are the ones that are coming. All the time, they are the ones that are coming. Mr. Correct, we come to you from today. Sister Correct, we locate you from today. In the name of Jesus Christ. And you will be wondering, am I that bad? Why? 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 And you are looking at us, you say, even if we want to eat frog, we will eat the one that has fat. This one has fat. This one does not have fat. Wrong people always propose. I call that the spirit of evil madness. Evil madness. Your life is just magnetizing wrong people. Every power of evil madness in your life, I break it by fire. I break it completely. Say evil magnet. Break by fire. Evil magnet in my life. Break by fire. In the name of Jesus. There's also the problem of unusual pattern of broken promises and engagement. Broken promises. For some, people are proposing, but they are not following it. For some, they've gotten engaged. They've had engagement, but at the point of breakthrough, people just broke up. I know somebody, I didn't know, but I've heard the story, and from good authority, somebody that called off marriage on the money of the marriage. The day the marriage is supposed to take place, someone who cannot lie shared a story. That's my father-in-law, Pastor Brown. He just shared the story of someone in the church that he used to pastor. On the morning of wedding, the man disappeared and went back to America. This was a man who traveled down, they had courtship, they had everything. He disappeared on the morning of the wedding. The woman almost went mad. They had to send her to rehabilitation. But the grace of God rehabilitated her. But today she's happily married. Broken engagement. Now, I know someone, this is someone that I know with my two eyes, that had proposals and had engagement, at least of all the proposals and near marriage day syndrome that she suffered. I know three of them. There were probably more, but I know three of them. Everything agreed. Promises, one of them broke after they had agreed to go to registry. Just a few days to go to registry. The man said, I don't want you anymore. And he left. Bye-bye. I know that one. Then the next one that happened to this lady was that everything agreed. The man, in fact, they've done their courtship in church. They've done their marriage counseling in church, put everything together, and they printed cards. Wedding cards, distributed wedding cards. Now it was exactly 1 week to the wedding. Saturday morning, 1 week to come, another Saturday to come to the wedding. And then immigration officials in this country. Some of you are looking at me, I'm a carrier of British passport, I have American passport. What's this man talking about? You know, he's talking to me stuff that I don't understand. I didn't hurt devil didn't hurt me, I'm just going my own. So why is he preaching this stuff at me? It's you I'm preaching it at. Because it's the truth. The truth is constant. Whether you are in America, in Africa, in Honolulu, in Casablanca, in Kotangura, in Okokomaiko, wherever you are, in Liverpool, Manchester, Bedford, and Bradford, anywhere you are, truth is constant. And you shall know the truth will make you free. Truth is constant. 1 week exactly to wedding that has been prepared, elaborately packaged and prepared, immigration officials knock at our door in this country. And so, yeah, let's go. Let's go where? Then we are taking you back to Libya. What are you talking about? Well, you check our records. You don't have to. And this was even a time when things were easy. In terms of immigration, nobody talking to anybody. I'm talking of some 12 years ago. They said, you are going. He said, no, you must be joking. He went God, and she's working a good job as a nurse in this country. He said, they gave me permission to work. They are working on my paper. This is my letter. This is my letter. Look, do you know that they didn't look at her letter? They did not look at her letter. Please come with us. Policemen were there. Immigration men were there. You would think that they came to arrest a criminal. More than 10 of them. It's very early in the morning at 6 a.m. Before she could call Jack Robinson, the plane had taken off. She landed in Lagos. 1 week to the wedding. What happened? I still saw this person 3 years ago. She's still single. Every pattern of broken promises in your life, that same pattern is hereby broken in the name of Jesus Christ. All those who have promised to help you and they keep breaking their promises, may the Almighty God take away their sleep from them. In the name of Jesus. Until they come quickly and speedily to help you in that area of your life where you desire and deserve to be helped. There is also the problem of anger. Anger spirit can cause marital delay. Beloved, nobody wants to marry an angry woman or an angry husband. No woman wants to become a punching bag in your hand. The moment they see that if this one gets angry, and you too, you are proposing to a lady, maybe you are just talking to one and say, don't cause my anger. If I'm the woman, I will tell you, it's not only your anger I will not cause, even you yourself, I will not cause you. Bye-bye. I will run. Anger lies in the bosom of a fool. You will not marry a fool. Your children, my children, will not marry fools. In the name of Jesus. I call that category character disorder. Character disorder in some people is responsible for marital delay in their life. Some people have domineering attitude. You think a man wants to marry a woman who will become the husband in his house? No man wants that. No man wants. Or you think a woman wants to marry a man who will be using her as carpet and walking over, bossy, from your statements, your sentences alone? They can decide that this one has a domineering attitude. Let me wrong. That's why they are wrong. Disobedience can also lead to delay. Disobedience is when you reject God's offer. God's best gifts do not always come in the most attractive packaging. Learn to accept what God has given you. Thank you, Lord. Prayerlessness can lead to marital delay. When you are prayerless, can lead to marital delay. Now, there are also some physical causes. Quickly, let me run through that because of our time. Number one, parental or peer pressure is a physical cause that can lead to marital delay. Parental peer pressure leading to wrong counsel. When they are giving you wrong counsel, your parents are saying, no. This one is the one you should marry. We belong to the same club. We are friends. That has brought problems to many, many ladies and many men because of ungodly pressure that came to them. Another one is what I call seeking Mr. and Miss Perfect. Looking for Mr. Perfect and Miss Perfect. Some are looking for perfection that they can't find in this world. This is how she must look. She must have 22, 23 in statistics. She must carry this look. She must have this kind of set of teeth. Her hair too must be like this. And all that. You are listing a long list. You are looking for a Miss Perfect. If you are looking for a perfect man, a perfect woman to marry, you will go to heaven and marry an angel. And do you know what? When you marry that perfect angel, you are in trouble. Because 24/7, the angel will just say, Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Give me attention now. Hallelujah. I mean, am I not a human being? Won't you look at me? Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Some of you are looking for Mr. Perfect. Mr. Perfect. God is the one that perfects all that concerns us. There may just be something you are missing when you are looking for that Mr. Perfect. Some of us, our parents are looking for Mr. Perfect for us to marry. Or Sister Perfect for us to marry. So our parents are giving us a long list of arms and conditions. He doesn't have paper. Don't marry. He doesn't have, he's not a chartered accountant. Don't marry. It's not a medical. You know, in this home, you either marry a lawyer, a medical doctor, or truth correctly. Am I a lawyer today? Even though I'm not a liar. But I'm not a lawyer. By training, by profession, by some years, where I still have my certificate and license, I'm not practicing law. Don't look for Mr. Pastor. Don't look for Mr. Pastor. Look for God's will. God's will for your life. Hear God, listen to what God is saying. And go into it by faith. And the Lord will perfect all that concerns you. Another enemy that brings marital delay in people's life, I'm talking about difficulties now, is poor interpersonal relationship. If you want friends, make yourself friendly. Brothers can't talk to some sisters because they are not approachable. They are not approachable. Their faces are already saying, get away, I don't want to talk to anybody. I'm not in the mood. And they are never in the mood to talk. That's why men are running from you. That's why women are running from you. Because every time you are walking like a soldier just came from Iraq. And don't know where the next bullet is coming to come from. Change that has from interpersonal relationship. Relate to people. The Bible says that he who wants to make friends must make himself friendly. I beg, make yourself friendly. A friendly attitude is not a sign of holiness in you. Make yourself friendly. Relate to people. Have good, excellent interpersonal relationship. Praise the name of the Lord. And that doesn't mean that everybody will take you for granted. And those who take you for granted for that kind of attitude and character style, they will have themselves to blame. They will have themselves to blame. Those who think that because you are friendly, you want to speak to them, they will have themselves to blame. Because by the time if they come the way they are not supposed to come, the knockout they are going to get will knock them down. It will take a long time for them to rise up. You never fail when you are on the side of God. You only succeed. Another problem of delay, physical problem we are talking about, would be what I call poor personal hygiene. Poor personal hygiene. Look after yourself. Look after yourself very well. Praise God. Some of us, men and women, we have body odors. We are not doing anything about that. In spite of billions of colognes that have been manufactured, in spite of trillions of medicated soap that have been made, we are not looking after our personal hygiene. Nobody is permitted to wear one part twice or what. Praise God. Work on yourself. Work on your personal hygiene. Praise God. Am I making sense? Yes. Yes. You only have this body for one lifetime. You don't have it forever. Only for one lifetime. Don't disfigure it. Don't discolor it. Black is beautiful. White is wonderful. Work on your personal hygiene. Brush your teeth very well. When you are fasting, use mint. Use mouthwash regularly. In conversation, that's good thing. Good hair. When you are speaking and people are turning like this, it should give you a sign. Work on your personal hygiene. It can be because of marital delay for some people. And you don't, and you know people won't say that in house. People won't come to you and say, you have body odor. No, they won't. That's the danger in it. They won't tell you. But they will not do after, they will not want to marry you or do anything with you. You have to work on this. And it doesn't matter whether you are married or unmarried. Even when you are already married, don't neglect. Some of us only work on our personal hygiene before we get married. The moment we are married, that one will go on sabbatical. We think, well, after all, no man is looking at me again. What about the husband? Some of us have lost our husband. We've lost our wife. Because we no longer look after ourselves. Particularly women. Work on your personal hygiene. Work on yourself. Work on your body. Praise God. Praise God. You don't necessarily have to be a slimmer to work on yourself. Good flesh in the body is also good. Work on it and look good, smell good. Mommy said, taste good. I didn't say so. It's mommy that said so. She said, taste good. Let somebody shout hallelujah. is also related to working on personal hygiene is dress appropriately. Dress well. One of the things why nobody goes to some sister is that they dress like prostitutes. And these men that you are looking at, let me tell you a secret. Men that you are looking at, potential suitors that you are looking at, they may love to sleep with those who dress like prostitutes, but they don't want to marry those who dress like prostitutes. No man wants to marry them, but they want to sleep with them. That's men for you. That's men for you. So when you dress like a prostitute, you are only moving that department of a man that wants to sleep with you. You are not moving the department of his life that wants to marry you. Praise God. Don't dress in an unholy manner. Don't dress anyhow. You dress and 70% of what you exclusively belong to your husband is exposed to the whole world. You think any man wants that? It's a lie. They don't want that. They don't want that. You dress in such a way that when you appear in front of a man, the man, if he wants to make heaven, he must close his eyes. You dress in such a way, and you know you are coming to church, and there will be praise worship. And you know when praise will start, the choir will lead the song, Benlo, 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 and see what the Lord has done. And then you dress so that the whole world can see, not what the Lord has done for you spiritually to bless you, but how you have been fearfully and wonderfully created. But that bear is not good that way. It's not good. There are two things that can make me move my face away and not make eye contact with a woman when I'm speaking to you. One could be because of mouth odor. And secondly, could be because of how you treated your chest. So when you notice that I'm speaking to you and I'm not making eye contact, that's a secret. Could be for those two reasons. Because I want to be comfortable speaking to you, but most importantly, I want to make heaven. I want to make heaven. Please, I want to make heaven. And I'm a man. I'm just a human being. I'm a man. I don't want to fall. I want to make heaven. Amen. Now, before you clap your hands too much, now, that is unholy dressing. Now, there is also the other extreme. Too holy dressing. That one, too, can cause marital disease. Eh? Too holy. You dress as if you are the only one who desires to make heaven. And wearing too much of buba and iro is not also good. Buba and iro has a way of hiding your figure completely. Amen. In marriage, we are not looking for spiritual attraction. Men are also looking for physical attraction. And the same thing with women. Women are looking, they want you to be smart. And women generally love smart men. There's a saying that the way you are dressed is the way you are addressed. Women love smart men. Women don't love men who dress anyhow, shabbily. And I may not have anything against men who put hole inside their ears and put, but what I can tell you is that majority of sisters will not agree to propose to them. People generally love responsible people, and things like that don't show signs of responsibility. Don't ask me where I read in the Bible that you can't cut your hair, but I'm telling you reality. Even me, if I get daughter, I don't go allow my daughter. Men, brothers, dress well. If you are not dressing well in this church, who do you resemble? Not me, and I'm your father in the Lord. And I'm your father in the Lord. And you don't need big money to dress well. Ask my wife. When I met her, somebody just brought me a car. And that car, when you start the car, the smoke will reach Elephant and Castle. But I believe that there was something she found irresistible with me. I dress well. I dress well. Little that I had only two suits. But those two suits, the way I interchanged them with the three shells and two ties that I had, you will think that I have dozens of them. But those three shells, I will iron them, starch them very well. If you move too near, the gator can cut your, the line can cut your body. Somebody shout hallelujah. More in me all, here I come. Mozambique all, here I come. So when they see me, I say, Mr. Speaker is coming. I didn't have money. I came from a poor home. Mr. Speaker is coming. Which woman will not like Mr. Speaker? So when my wife saw me, she ignored all other factors. Said, this one is a marriageable material. Put your hands together. Work on yourself. Don't dress like a harlot. And don't dress as if you're the only male. Hey, hallelujah. We shall overcome today. Tribalism can also be a cause of marital delay. You have vowed that you will not marry any other person other than your woman, or other than someone who came from a particular tribe or your own tribe. That can, you can be on the queue for a long time. Tribalism, it is God that gives. These things don't really matter. It's what you hear from God and pray to God. As I close, lack of balance in life. You must put some balance in your life. Your life must not be 24/7 in church, and your life must not be 24/7 anywhere outside the church. Let there be a balance in your life. Nobody wants to marry a jobless man, even if you are a prayer warrior number one in your church, and you pray 24/7, you don't have a job in your hand. No woman wants to marry you. Nobody wants to marry a woman that will not have time to cook good food at home. Nobody looks there, or spend time or stay their lives, or go on holiday. Let there be balance in your life. Amen? Let there be balance. God is the God of balance. Many times in the Garden of Eden, the Bible says God will come to who? To Adam in the cool of the day, just for them to have fellowship and interact and chat. Relax. Thank you. Tell your neighbor, relax. Finally, how do I overcome delay? Overcome delay by surrendering your life to Jesus today. Live holy. Pray with understanding. Be determined to obey God no matter what. Examine your life and make amends where necessary. Do a spiritual mapping. Discover if you can find any of the things I've been talking about in any area of your life, and get ready to war in spiritual warfare and overcome. Be planted in the church and don't forsake the assembly of brethren. Psalm 92:13 says, they that are planted in the house of the Lord shall flourish in the courts of our God. I know people who have been planted in the house of God for many, many years, even though they were single, even though single parents, for the time and the season came, God visited them, and they are happily married today. Be planted in the house of God. Be kind, be generous, be a giver, be affectionate, be helpful. Use what I call the Rebecca formula. And your husband will manifest by fire. Your wife will come forth. Be generous. Be kind to everybody. Be helpful. Look for what you can do to make life easier and better for people around you. And also, be anxious for nothing. Don't be afraid. Have no fear. Your time and your season are gone. Finally, invest in yourself. The waiting time should be 20 times. Invest in yourself. Nobody wants to marry an educated illiterate. And some men, some women are educated illiterates. Even though you may have PhD, but you can be an illiterate when it comes to some basic things that you ought to know. For instance, you are proposing to a young woman, you are a young man proposing to a young woman. Both of you may be graduates, but the lady now asks you, or the brother asks you, can I have your email address? And you say, email? What is email? Or I don't have an email address. In this age and time, irrespective of your first class degree, I've never used one before, you know. That's illiteracy. And no man, no woman wants to stick around with an educated illiterate. Invest in yourself. Know from basic things. Have some understanding of current affairs. You are not living in a world of your own. Be a conversationist. Have communication skills. Be able to go into good conversation. Don't run away from conversation simply because you have low self-esteem or you are afraid that you are going to batter grammar. Go and improve yourself if need be. There are schools online everywhere. Invest in yourself. Look good for your God. You are fearfully and wonderfully created and made by Him. And all His blessings are yours. Rise up and receive. Thank you, Jesus. To Him alone be the glory. All eyes closed. If you are here this afternoon, you have not surrendered your life to Jesus. That's the starting point. To break and destroy every form of delay in your life, that's the starting point. If you are here, you want to give your life to Christ, make Him your Lord and your Savior, repent from any form of sin, raise up your right hand, and I'm going to pray with you. Anyone like that, this is your day of new beginning. Don't miss this day. God bless you, my daughter. God bless you. Yes, anyone else, my beloved sister, God bless you. Raise up your right hand above your head if you want to rededicate your life to Christ today. That's the starting point. The one who delivered me from the bondage of delay and denial. The one who wrote off and removed every curse that they placed on me, on my family, because of polygamy, because of separation and divorce of parents. That same God is here today and He wants to do a new thing in your life. Anyone else, God bless you, God bless you. It's your day, it's your day. God bless you. I want everybody to remain quiet, silent, and remain where you are in the house. This is a wonderful moment. God bless you. Yes, if you are joining this wonderful children of God now, raise up your hand so that we can pray together. God bless you. If you have received a card, and I know you are not ashamed of Jesus Christ, and the only one that is ashamed now is the devil, I want you to come forward. I want you to come forward. Come forward majestically with confidence. It's your day. It's your day. Don't let the enemy steal your day from you. If you have received a card, come forward. I want to pray for you on this altar. Just come. Just come. Jesus Christ said there will be rejoicing before the angels if one soul shall return to the Lord. What a beautiful day that Christ is rejoicing before the angels and dancing just because of you. Anyone else, if you want to join, come forward now and declare for Jesus and say, get thee behind me, Satan. Shall we pray? Pray for yourself, my brother and my sister. Ask the Lord to receive you, to forgive your sins, to cleanse you. Ask the Lord to write His name in the book of life. Ask the Lord to begin to use you mightily, mightily for His glory. Ask the Lord to take away every property of the devil that is in your life. Ask the Lord to cut off the hand of Satan from your life. And ask the Lord to terminate every form of delayed blessing in your life from this day. My Father and my God, thank you for your son and your daughter. Only you can save his soul, and only you will administer to your children. I pray in the name that is above another name, that today you will have mercy on them, that today you write their names in the book of life, and from now begin to use them mightily for your glory. Every form of delay of the enemy in their life, terminate it completely today. From now on, my Father, let it be well with these children. In Jesus' name, we pray. Amen. I'd like to shake hands with you, and of course, if you look towards your right, my pastors will be willing to meet with you, collect the cards from you, and give you a couple of gifts. Please go with Pastor Moses. Please, let's appreciate Jesus in them. Let's appreciate Jesus in their lives. Amen. 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 And let's pray a couple of prayers, and we are done. Lift up your hand and pray it well. Beloved, this is the end of the year, and this is a season that we must not do with any problem that the devil has a hand in our life. Say, every chain of delay, holding down my destiny, I command you to break. In the name of Jesus. Pray, 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 pray. In Acts chapter 16, there was a chain holding down Saul, Paul and Silas. Those chains were broken by the earthquake of God. I command every chain of delay and denial, delayed breakthrough, delayed joy, delayed fulfillment of my dream, every chain of delay, I command you to break. I command you to break. Break now. Break now. Break now. Break now. Break now. Break now. Reka pokotoya la brakatata. In Jesus' name we pray. Every part family, in my family, your time is all. Be dissolved by the blood of Jesus. Every cause of delay, every pattern of delay in my family, be dissolved by the blood of Jesus. Go ahead, let them be dissolved. Let them be dissolved. Let that cause be nullified by the blood of Jesus. Let that cause be reversed by the blood of Jesus. Every cause of delay, marital delay, breakthrough delay, delayed childbearing, delayed marriages, delayed manifestation, delayed fulfillment of your dream, delay realization of God's plan and purpose, delay manifestation of what you know God has promised expressly in your life. Let that pattern in my family break. Let it break. Let it be dissolved by the blood of Jesus. Nekaporia daliskete, jelebo zaneria makukataya, e nakatoria nariskatelia, jelebo shanderia makapragasata, ikapokotonde bradazanta. In Jesus' name we pray. Say, oh Lord, begin to fast track my all-round breakthrough in the name of Jesus. Pray, 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 pray. My Father, my God, in the name of Jesus, begin to fast track my all-round breakthrough. Begin to fast track them. Begin to fast track them. Master Neria, Jerebo, don't you bradis kataya. Nika poko to bradis kataya. Nika la ba 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 ba. In Jesus' name we pray. Say, every problem of delay in my life, be it physical or spiritual, every problem of delay in my life, be it spiritual or physical, today, by the blood of Jesus, receive solution in the name of Jesus. Pray, 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 pray. Pray, 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 pray. Every form of delay in my life, every form of delay, spiritual and physical, receive solution. Receive solution. Receive solution. Receive solution today, today. Receive solution. In Jesus' name we pray. Say, my Father, send your glory of the latter house and let my star arise and begin to shine. My Father, send your glory of the latter house. Let my star arise and begin to shine. Let me make progress. Let me go forward. Let me fulfill destiny. Let me do exploit in the name of Jesus. Pray, 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 pray. Let me fulfill the very purpose you have created me. The glory of the latter house shall be greater than that of the former. The glory of the end of the year must be greater than that of the beginning of the year. Oh Lord my God. Oh Lord my God. Let the glory of the latter house, let it come upon me right now to fast track my destiny, to cause my star to arise and to shine. In Jesus' name we pray. As we close, the Bible says in the book of Ezekiel, the word that I, the Lord, have spoken unto you, they will no more be prolonged. You want to pray and say, thou promises of God for my life, thou promises of God for my family, you will no more be prolonged, manifest by signs and wonders in the name of Jesus. Pray, 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 pray. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, Lord. Manifest, 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 manifest. Manifest, manifest, manifest. Manifest, manifest, manifest. Manifest. The promises of God will no longer be delayed. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Finally, say, my Father, as you prepare me, my family, your church, and my nation for the new year, give us joy, peace, protection, security, laughter, new song, testimony. Father, as you prepare me, my family, your church, and my nation, give us joy, peace, security, protection, new laughter, new song. In the name of Jesus, pray, 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 pray. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Father. Blessed be thou your name, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Just lift up your hands and take this song only once. Lord, prepare me to be a sanctuary.
name of Jesus. You are on top, you are still rising. You are unstoppable. You will reach your goal in the name of Jesus. God will fortify you and your family. You will not have sorrow over any of us. You will make heaven and you will take many of us with you. In the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, agent of this. For in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Praise the Lord. Please let us be seated. It's an opportunity to break every chain of delay concerning our finances by bringing our tithe to the storehouse and giving. To take over all that the enemy has stolen from you in the name of Jesus. All the blessings that the Almighty God has programmed into 2012 for you, 2012 will not swallow them, 2012 will not carry them away. All of them will yet be delivered to your hands in the name of Jesus. Every problem that the enemy has programmed for you in 2012, in the name of Jesus Christ, you are separated from them all. You will not carry any of those problems on to the new year. In the name of Jesus. As the gate of 2012 is closing, sickness closes down concerning you. Poverty closes down concerning you. Failure comes to an end concerning you. Trial, tragedy, and sorrow, they all close down concerning you. In the name of Jesus. As the gates of 2013 are about to open, may they open for your sake. May they open with joy to be handed to you. As they are opening up, let them hand over breakthrough to you. Let them hand over progress to you. Let them